Hello guys, welcome back to our channel Tech Lovers. In this session, we are going to discuss about creating a reversal using C programming. Before going to start, if anybody interested in joining with me, I am available on Discord. I am maintaining a Discord server to our channel, so I am going to provide the link, joining link, in the description. So the C programming will be as it will function like as MSF Enum payload. And one more information I need to give: I stopped doing videos on Nmap because I do not have enough time to do. Later I will continue the series. I will definitely complete the whole series and I will give the complete information about Nmap. So let's go. Shell.c. Let's create. Sorry, I created a reversal.c. So I am going to write the code first and later then I will explain. So up to that, please enjoy the background music that I am going to provide. Please make comfortable while I am writing code. So here you go. Enjoy the music until I write the code. You enjoy the music. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity.
It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity. It's all about humanity.
Yes, that's it guys. We connected, we successfully created a reverse shell using Netcat, and through C programming. So let's go to the code and let me explain what I did. So let us run some commands here. Yes, it's running successfully. Okay, let's go to the code of the program. Let's see what we did. Okay. So here we, at starting I included some of the header files. I think all members know what these two function, these two headers will do. So this is this header file is used for some type of system calls like exccv. It's a system call. So the type of system calls are included in this header file. So in order to do that, we need to include this header file. And so as a part of networking, so we are working on networking networks, so we need a socket. All might know what a socket is. A socket is a connection between a local host and local port. So we created a port here, and we created a local host means AFINET. AFINET represents the IP address of version v4 or v6. So in order to connect or bind that two things, I am included this file and netinet.in.h. So to connect those things, the system means the functions will be in netinet/in.h, and this unist.h header file we included because to encode the characters that we are giving in the commands. So these are the purposes of header files that we are included. And here we created a local variable named socket and another local variable called port, and a structural variable SOC address and rev SOC address. So here when we created a socket, then the SOC address and reverse SOC address will be of same values, and the reverse SOC and reverse SOC address and reverse SOC address will be binded to the to the attackers. So in order to do that, we use a structure variable. Here while we creating a socket, we need to pass three arguments. So this part represents what type of IP address we are using. So as I defined, as I given here AFINET, so it represents whether the IP is of version v4 or v6. So it is of type SOC stream, and if you given 0, the victim's computer or compromised machine will provide the port. Port means it will run on which port, like TCP or UDP. So if you mention TCP, it will give the connection, it will establish a connection to using TCP protocol. If you mention here UDP, it will establish the connection using UDP protocol. But I suggest here to keep 0 as it is in order to avoid the errors in our code. So here this is called the SYN family. So here I am assigning that SYN family to take the IP address as IPv4 or IPv6, and this extends function call is here to convert that unsigned integer to the network's byte. So here the port is 8080, and an unsigned integer is converting to the network's. So and this is the IP address that that we want to loop back to our attacker's machine. So as I am using my Windows vulnerable machine, so I using my Windows machine IP address to connect back to my Windows machine. So successfully we created it, and later mentioning it, we need to connect. After creating socket and after mentioning these all ports, we need to connect the socket. We need to connect the socket to victim and attacker. So I did it here. So socket and reverse SOC address I connected here, and this dupe2 function is known for file descriptor. So we need to use it, otherwise we are unable to create the files. Means we are unable to create the reversal of our Kali Linux machine. So here I think all members know what this hash trick represents. it represents a pointer, and argv is a one dimensional array. So in this array we are going to pass our commands. So basic and I pass the command initially that it is a /bin/bash. So all members know that Windows terminal runs on bash scripting. So I pass it here, and another argument is null. So later I created a exe/cve system call. So exe/cve system call is basic, most powerful and basic Unix means Linux system call. I used it and I exploited while creating a reverse shell. So I think all members know what we, I think all members understand what we did right now. If any errors or any doubts you have, you please leave a comment. And if you like the content in the video, please like and subscribe for the class. And I am going to upload new videos on exploiting Stack Overflow and Buffer Overflow, and later videos on I will upload the video as this as likely to this version. Means I am going to create a reverse shell using Python scripting. Now I did using C programming. Later video I am going to upload using it using Python. So stay tuned for new updates. If you like the content, please like and share and subscribe to TechLouse. Have a great day.